Good morning, children. How are you all? Hope you all are doing good. So in computers, we were doing with chapter 4, personalizing Windows 7. In the previous class, we saw what is desktop personalization. Then we saw some of the personalized user accounts on a system. Then we also saw how we can set desktop background, window color and screensaver. Hope you all have practiced the second and third points. Okay, now today we shall see the remaining topics of the chapter. Today we shall see switching between the windows, jump lists. That is one of the Windows 7 feature. Then we shall also see about files and folders and how we can create, how we can open files and folders. Today's topics I shall be covering in two videos. The first two topics I shall be covering in the first video, and the remaining topic, files and folders, I shall be covering in the second video. Okay, so we shall start switching between the windows. Now, what is a window? Okay, any program or any application like MS Word, Notepad, MS Logo, MS Paint. So, any program or application that you open, some screen appears in front of you all, some display, some dialog box appears in front of you all. That is called as a window, and that is also called as a viewing area of that program. It has all the options and the features to work with that program. Okay, now what all we can do with the window? Okay, we can open more than one window, and if we can open more than one window, we can switch between the windows. But we can work only with one window at a time. And the window that we are working, it appears above all the other windows and darker. It appears with the dark border and the dark taskbar. Now we shall see all these four points on the system. So this is our system. Now I shall open 3-4 applications or 3-4 files, 3-4 programs I shall open. First I shall open with the Word. Okay, I am opening a Word file. Any Word file you can open, or you can open from here. Okay, so this Word, let's say I want to work with this file. Okay, so I have opened a Word file. Okay, it has opened in a window. This is called as a window. This is the Word window. Okay, it has all the options and features to work with the Word application. These are all the options and the features of this Word window. Now let us open some other file or program. Okay, so the window is appeared not in the maximum size. I have restored it to some smaller size than the maximum. Now let us minimize this and let us open this media file.
Hello everyone. In this video, we're going to talk about the difference between a hub, a switch, and...
I'm restoring it to some smaller size. Okay, so I have restored it to a smaller size than the maximum. Okay? Now, we have opened a Word file and a media file. Okay, now let us see the taskbar. On task bar, you shall see this highlighting and this highlighting, okay? Which means I am working on a Word file and a media file. Okay, two programs, two applications, two tasks are opened and I am working on these two. So which means I can open more than one window. So whatever windows, whatever applications, whatever programs, files, folders that you open, they appear on the task bar. So you can work with them. Now how I can switch? If you want to switch, if you have opened so many windows, let us open so many windows. I have opened this also, then I have opened this browser window also. Okay, see, so many windows I have opened. I have opened a folder, I have opened a browser, then I have opened a media file, a Word file. Okay, so four I have opened. So these four, they appear this way. Okay? So how I can switch? I can switch by either clicking on the taskbar, that is, if I want to work with the folder, I shall click on the folder on the taskbar. It will appear in front of all the other windows. See. If I want to work with the browser, I shall click on this and it shall appear above all the other windows. See, it is in front of all the other windows. If you want to work with the Word, click on the Word and it shall appear above all the other windows. Okay, so this way we can switch. You can switch from the windows also. If you can see the windows, okay, some windows we can see behind this Word window, so you can just click on their click on them, so they shall appear. So from here also you can switch. Okay, you just click on the window, it shall appear above all the other windows. Okay, so either you can switch from here or you can switch by clicking on the windows. Now, though we can open more than one window, we can switch between the windows, but we can work only with the one window at a time. That is, the window which appears in front of all the other windows, above all the other windows, we are working on that window and we can work only with one window at a time. That is, if this window is in front of all the above other windows, so I can work only with this window. I cannot work with these windows. If I want to work, I will have to click on that, bring that window in front of all the other windows, and I can work with this window then. Okay? So this way. Now, window which appears in front of all the other windows, that is above all the other windows, it appears darker. See its border. See its border and see the borders of other windows. They are lighter and this is darker. And also on the taskbar, see, this is darker than the other programs. Okay, this is more darker. This is more darker than the other three programs. Okay, so these were the points in switching between the windows. Now we shall see the next topic, jump lists. So what is jump list? Jump list is one of the features of the Windows 7. What we can do with this feature? This feature helps us to get quickly to the items like recently opened and the favorite items. Items meaning any files, folders or websites. Okay, so we can get to these recently opened and favorite items quickly. Favorite items meaning we can pin them on the taskbar. Pinning is this. I shall show you. Okay. And Once you have pinned, you can see a jump list and you can get to the recently opened items from that jump list. Okay, now let us see this jump list on the system. So if you want to see a jump list, what you can do is, now I have, let us see the jump list of this media player. Okay, this file, just right click on it, right click on it, and you shall see this one small list appears. Okay, this is called as a jump list. What all you can see in this jump list? The recently opened items. Okay, so recently I opened these two media files. And there is one small, this line, below this line you can see the name of the program. There is an option to unpin. Unpin meaning this program is pinned on this taskbar. The programs that we want to work regularly or more frequently, we can pin those programs on the taskbar. Pinning meaning you can fix them. You can fix them on the taskbar. So whenever you start your system, you will see these programs here on the taskbar. You don't have to go to start button, then you are going to the program. So all those long steps, you can just short it, you can cut it to this way. Then there is the last option, that is close window. So if you want to go to any of the recently files, you can go from here, you can just select. So this will open. Okay, I have opened this file from the recently items. Okay, so I am closing this. So these programs are pinned. I shall show you, I shall open one of the programs that we can pin. Let's say I have opened this Excel file. Now this is not pinned. So let's say I am working on this file and I want this file to be pinned on the taskbar. This program, this application to be pinned on the taskbar. What shall I do? I shall go to this application. As I have opened, it appears on the taskbar. I shall right click on it and there is an option I see which is pin this program to taskbar. So when I click on this, it shall pin this application, Excel application, on the taskbar. So let us try this. Click and I am closing this. Now after closing, you shall see one Excel, MS Excel icon here. Okay, so this is pinned. These are all pinned here on the taskbar. So you can pin your favorites, you can open your recently the items that you are working on, that you have recently worked on, you can see by using this jump list feature. Okay, so we saw how we can switch between the windows and jump lists.